billions and billions to stimulate a crippled economy. The Japanese reaction? Been there, done that.
If Japanese can do it, there's no reason Americans cannot do it.
Richard Koo is the chief economist at a major Japanese securities firm, whose book details how in the 1990s, Japan, a nation with half the population of the U.S., ended up spending more than $6 trillion, mostly on construction jobs like those in the U.S. stimulus plan. It stabilized the economy and slowly started a recovery, but then a mistake. Seeing progress in a couple of years, Japan shifted from making jobs to paying down the deficit.
Economy improved, and then we said, oh, the budget deficit is too large, we cut it. Economy collapsed again.
So a recession that might have ended in a few years went on for more than a decade. And there is also the fear factor. Japanese banks then, like American banks now, cut interest rates to almost zero. But people scared of new debt saved instead of borrowing.
The same psychology is driving American consumers now. A year ago, the American savings rate was less than 1%. In the last few months, it has climbed to 2.9%.
Scared consumers are hunkering down, and down go sales, like cars, off almost 40% in the U.S. in January from a year ago. Get the economic stimulus right, and in a few years, the U.S. economy should take a turn for the better.
There is a way out that we don't have to suffer a Great Depression or major recession.
But get it wrong, stop the stimulus too soon, as Japan did, and the economy could be on life support for a decade or more. Barry Peterson, CBS News, Tokyo.